We're recording. This is Old Home Week here. This is the RPG Chick, Amethyst Lunatari, here with Eye of the Beholder 3. And yes, this is the beginning. Basically, what you're seeing here on the right is a map. The all-seeing eye for Eye of the Beholder 3. Actually, a separate program from the first two. But I just want to say, before I get into everything here, I want to say thanks to big, mega, huge thanks to Planetdune for editing and effectively converting my Amiga info, my saves, characters, items, etc., from the Amiga over to the PC version, Eye of the Beholder 3. Unfortunately, it was never released for the Amiga, and some people have requested me to play this, and I've resisted doing so because there was no map like in the first two, and it's, you know, I could have printed out maps and gone that way, but I was like, eh. So this shows you a map, so I'm gonna get into a lot of info, some of it while I play, so won't be boring as hell to you guys, because we're going to be doing a lot of chopping down of trees, unfortunately. But Planetdune did a lot of work, an unbelievable amount of work. But all in all, probably as much work as I did getting this working with the all-seeing eye and getting the MT32 Roland sound working. I got what a headache I had with that one. Don't use DOSBox 0.4. The sound is choppy as hell. I actually have this on GOG and ended up not using the GOG version, but using Planetdune's version and then converting it with ASOP 32 to make it 32-bit rather than 16. I mean, maybe it was already that way, but his version was running really slow for me, so I converted it that way, and yeah, he did a lot of work, and I'm going to be reading some of what he wrote me. Hope he doesn't mind that. So big shout out to Planetdune. You are the man. If you ever need help with anything, don't know if I can, but try. Let me know. So we're breaking camp. Here is the map to the right. And what it doesn't show you, okay, are these stupid things. If you go like this and highlight, we can go do the all attack. Now I can highlight the other two, but be a little strategic here, I would do soon there. There's someone come up on the side as well. Ah! It's quick. And unfortunately it messes up the map here, I guess. You there! Halt! I am Faerûn Falconhand, leader of the Knights of Myth Drannor, and we are here to discourage any further looting from this once grand city. Thieves will not be tolerated. Both. All the above. We are heroes from Waterdeep, here to investigate a great evil. Waterdeep, eh? You're a long way from home. Now, how long do we get teleported? I'm going to be into the intro in a bit. Elminster said that a group of heroes from far away would help rid this land of evil. Much like yourselves, we are here searching for an evil that seems to have rooted itself here in these ruins. Perhaps you will have better luck than we in revealing who or what is behind this. May fortune go with you, heroes of Waterdeep. Thank you. Now, why did my map screw up here? Here's the map. such as this. Yeah, save game has to be the same. So, I think what we have to do is save the game. Now, I have not loaded these two. This is basically his conversion right into the game here. So, what was the guy's name? Faerûn Falconhand? Okay. So breaking camp and then refresh the save game, and then we take Faerûn and we go search. Found several possible party. Oh god. Move the party. This is really difficult. Move the party, change direction in game, and click the row below, which changes as you move. I have to actually move. Right. This one. Okay. My, okay. So I don't know why that knocked us out. So you can see it updating there. See these stupid things? Unfortunately, you don't see them disappear or, you know, be destroyed. They just are gone. In which case, you don't know if they've moved to the side of you or they actually are gone. Now, you can also go. It sounds like someone chopping down a tree, which you're going to be doing shortly. Yeah, it's fleeing. You see, it doesn't flee for long. A second here. Oh, we're getting hit. Now, as soon as we get rid of some of these things. Caramon says, some of these trees don't look all that sturdy to me. I wonder. I got a lot of stuff to talk about. These are characters, well, these two, anyway, characters inspired by the Dragonlance series of books. Caramon the Warrior, which looks like he found his brother Raistlin in the intro. And Gold Moon, the cleric. And this is my character, a mage. And here's Tagar from the first Eye of the Beholder. You encounter him. He joins your party. I don't remember that much about him. I know there's an encampment, a bunch of dwarves down there, and he was one of them. So he's an excellent fighter. Just gotta say. So, what about this stuff? Hold on 1 second. Yeah, if I can pause this. Okay. So, he says, here, I just want to read all this first. Planetdune. Yeah, Tagar is from Eye of the Beholder 1. As an NPC character, you could not replicate this hero straight into Eye of the Beholder 2. So you can't import from I1 into I3. You have to go from I2. So he was trying to replicate all my info into a save in I2. So what he had to do is he had to play through Eye of the Beholder 1 up to level 11, he says, where you find Tagar and then make a save game, and then he could import it into Eye of the Beholder 2, and then make a bunch of changes and import into here, into I3 here. So, yeah, Xanathar, I got a break this time. At that point, you could use the save game editor for all the I2 stuff, so you didn't need to play. I'd be older, too. So, the items that are missing are mostly quest items, Kelvin's coin, Starfire, the stone symbols for the, what do you call it, the portals that you use to teleport around. Pretty sweet. I think that was Eye of the Beholder 2. And there were a few minor irks that you could not fix, close as possible to the original party. It would be impossible to do everything exactly the same. All characters are the correct picture, name, gender, race, alignment, level, experience points, attributes, hit points, and armor class. Amethyst has the same spell scribed to her spellbook, and both Amethyst and Gold Moon have the same amount of spell points for each level. Caramon here. Missing item Starfire, because this is a quest item. So it would remove, it was, removed when, it would be removed anyway when importing to Eye the Beholder 3. Tagar has no missing items. Amethyst has ring slot 2. Yeah, different color for the Ring of Adornment. Ring of Wizardry. Ring of Adornment here, which is no AC anyway, but the, yeah, the Amiga version is blue, I believe. They don't share the same icon. There's no difference between this except for the icon color. So Gold Moon. That's for anyone who's interested in this. Bag slot 8. Here. Yeah, the potion here. Neutralized poison has a blue icon color in the DOS version and green on the Amiga. Maybe I got it reversed, because here it's green. Unless he changed some stuff around after that, I'm not completely sure. Yeah. Of the four main heroes, only the Starfire quest item is missing. Two icons of the same color. When you import, you can only choose four heroes, so you assume you'll continue the journey with the same four that transferred between Eye of the Beholder 1 and 2. Which is correct, thank you. The four listed above. That means the Calandra and Tanglor from Eye of the Beholder 2 will be dropped. Unfortunately, it only allows you to bring over two. These characters do hold items, and those will be lost. So he went over them, selected the more rare items, mostly magical items. Just don't have the inventory space to get everything. I don't feel like it'd be an extra standard helmet or boots, for example, are a great loss. You're correct there, Planetdune, yes. These are the items that which is kept for the other two characters. Composite bow, a +3 short sword, +4 dragon skin armor, lockpicks, +1 Brahma's boots, +2 plate mail, +1 helmet, +2 bandit armor, ring of sustenance, ring of featherfall, and +2 axe the bait, which is, I don't know, something has to do with the axe's bait. I don't even remember. I played these games in 2011, so it's kind of a little fuzzy right now. So the other items are discarded are common items such as duplicate skulls, a few potions, helmet, boots, non-magical weapons, and so on. Your Amiga save, you had 24 arrows. He's holding them here. 7+1 and 2+2 arrows. The 24 standard arrows are added to the DOS save. The +1 and +2 arrows are not. I tried multiple times, but each time the game crashed out. If I tried to hex edit those in, must be something with the way the quiver operates differently from all the other slots. It's a shame, but I don't think those 9 arrows would be a game changer. You are correct there. Yes. Mostly correct. I use the, or most correct. I use the car copy utility to prepare the save game and then imported it from the i3 main menu, and everything seemed to work fine. And some screenshots and stuff like that, which is, I'm not going to show you guys because you can see it here in the game for the most part. Basically just showing me how everything is the same, especially you can really easily see it with all the attributes and stats and so forth. And That's it. He had a quick look after he hex edited everything in, then he imported, and as expected, a lot of things were removed. They nerfed a few items. Plus one boots are now just boots. Changed some icons as well. The composite bow uses the normal bow icon. I don't know if that's the composite bow. I think it is. It's just a bow. I guess they changed the composite bow into a normal bow. And what do you say? Some unique looking shields revert to their original shield icon and so forth. Unfortunately, you know, it's pretty... I like unique looking things, but what can you do? The game defeats us, as it were. So, we have stuff. We have items, inventory management, we have bows. Caramon doesn't use these bows, so we find someone else who uses bows. I will do that, so... Potions of invisibility, potion of speed. Oh, this really matters, but... ring of protection +3, +2. Oh, we always do that. We show you guys... How do we get into... Yeah, here. Okay, so Caramon, here's his stats, because you guys might want to see that. He's level 9. I expect at certain points it's going to be a breeze getting through this game, because, as you see, we have quite a lot of magical weapons and such. I don't know if they've going to be changing up, you know, the difficulty of these things, these monsters, and such. But, I don't know. So, Tagor is a good dwarven male. Let's see these people's armor class. Negative 10. You can get lower than that at all. Negative 80 is also level 9. Here's me. Chaotic neutral half elf female mage. Level 11. And here's gold moon. Neutral good. Elven female cleric. Level 10. So we have some stuff to do here. So these are, yeah, the boots were changed into leather boots. We got leather boots. And he has a ring of protection +3 and +2. I just want to see something. If he's overstatted here, he's still -10 if we take off that +2 ring. And we have a +1 here. Take that off. 9. Wait. No, -8. I was looking at the level. -8. Okay, so all he needs is... Yep, we got all the 3, 2, and 1 here. So give him that. Then he's -10. Because my mage, the Ring of Adornment is worthless. Just looks nice. Ring of Wizardry, which I think grants me an extra spell? Or extra spells per level. I think it depends on my level. I'm not completely sure. But in any case, I can take... this ring of protection +3 and give it to her, and now she's armor class 2. Much better. So we have banded mail +2. He has Tagor already has plate mail +3. So this is, yeah, that's gonna be banded mail's not gonna be as good. But anyway. Regular plate mail. I'm curious. I went the wrong way. Regular plate mail versus banded mail, right? He's -10. If we switch that off, he's still -10. Let's see, here. We're really messing with the stats here. So really, he only needs a +1 ring of protection. He's -10 with that. So, regular plate mail, banded mail +2 is better. And he's got... Tagor's got plate mail +3. So good. He's also got braces of protection +5. He's holding a shield +3. He's got regular boots, formerly +1, I guess. A long sword +5. And... this bow can go to anybody. Let's see, rainbow invisibility. Plus, regular plate mail. He has a short sword plus 3. What does he have? A long sword plus 4. He's got the plate mail plus 3. Braces of protection plus 2. He's got a shield plus 3. Regular leather boots. Ring of sustenance. I think that stops you from... You don't need to eat anymore? I'm not completely sure. Ring of feather falling. Might as well hold on to that. Might as well put them on, right? As long as they're not cursed. So here we also have leather armor plus 4. Thieves tools. Plate mail plus 2. I mean, waste it. You can't get above minus... No, negative 10. With the Thaco. Two-handed sword plus 2. We also got this green crystal hammer plus 2, which... I guess the cleric can use? We see like you got a mace plus 3. No. These are regular leather boots. Two-handed sword. Potion of neutralized poison. Yeah, it is green. He has a regular helm. He has a regular helm. So this is like... stuff that we might not need at all. Unless we pick up another fighter. That's basically why I'm holding on to some of this stuff. This can definitely go to somebody else. So Tagor is minus 8, so if you give him this plus 2, boom, he's negative 10. Push him invisibility. I don't think, yeah, there's not any... There's no encumbrance in this, right? So they can just, as many slots as they need. So she's got dart plus 5, dart plus 5, dart plus 5. Here's her spell book, regular boots. Those things I just gave her, plus 3. Ring of Wizardry. Bracers of Protection. What does that do? Armor class 2. I don't know what it does. Maybe it protects against missile attacks or something. I don't know. A robe plus 3. She's got a regular helm. Surprised she can wear that. An axe plus 2. I need that soon. That's her ring of adornment. Garbage. Scrolls. True seeing. Invisibility. 10-foot radius. Fear. Fear. Invisibility. 10-foot radius. Haste. Ice storm. Pretty sweet. Cone of cold. And a cloak of protection. Oh, plus 3. Armor class 3. Yeah, it's slightly better than... Okay. And then finally, Gold Moon has a necklace of adornment, which doesn't do anything. She's wearing plate mail. I can get her some better mail. Plate mail. Plate mail plus 2. Alright, so her armor class is 0. We can fix that. Negative 2. Sweet. He has a shield plus 1. That's that hammer. Neutralize poison. Neutralize poison. I guess we'll give this to somebody else as well. Sorry guys, bear with me here. Spells, protection from evil, 10... Oh, you know why? That's because of beginning and end quotes. I thought it said 10 inches. remove paralysis, hold person, neutralize poison, and neutralize poison. So she's also got scrolls for neutralize poison. There's regular plate mail, shield plus 1. She needs her holy symbol, so she can't use a shield. Shield plus 1. Anyone wearing using a regular shield? Shield plus 3, okay. I guess that's extra stuff as well. So yeah, plate mail plus 2. Bracers of protection. She's got a ring of feather falling and a ring of protection plus 2. Regular boots. Here's her holy symbol. And stuff. And regular helms. We all have regular helms, I believe. Yeah, just helms. Now, I know I've been babbling on and on. There's not much to this area other than you fight these things. And you chop down trees. In which case... might as well just give him this. Because... let's see. Caramon remarks, a stout axe might well do the job. So you use a stout axe, and you go like this. Now, unfortunately, on the map, doesn't show all the details. There's not as much call for this as there was for the first two games. Yep, it takes you three. Tries. Some of these trees don't look all that sturdy to me. I wonder, after we chop some of them down. That didn't do anything. Now, there are a lot of cheats with this map, but I'm not going to be using the cheats. There is a cheat in a way that you can see from the map where it definitively ends. So you can tell here, if you look here, you'll see that we got solid lines here, but nothing here, which is basically a giveaway that, yeah. There's more. Now, somewhere along the way, I'm not sure completely where, we can find another axe. And yes, this is a blind playthrough, but I have played through this whole first area. Looking out for monsters. So this, yeah, I don't have the turn. I'd rather turn with the left arrow than strafe. So. Now, it was a major headache for me getting the MT-32 Roland sound working. As I think I mentioned, I just, no matter what I did, I could not get it working. And I never had so much trouble. Well, see, that's a hard line there, so that means... That's truly the end. Well, I'm gonna be chopping all this crap down. There's quite a bit. I don't know why they did it like this. Oh, we got a spirit. Hi. Attack. Don't you be flanking now. Ah, there's quite a bit. Well, these things really aren't a danger to us. As you see, we're not really getting hurt at all. I mean, I am avoiding them a little bit, but I'm not going out of my way. Now I could throw the darts, have Amethyst throw the darts. Gold Moon can't attack with her mace from back there. But I don't want to pick them up. I really don't want to pick them up, especially for these repetitive enemies that are not really hurting us. Really, we're all still full. No one's been injured, so... so sometimes I'm looking at the map, not really. I've been over there. Oh, we got more. Blocked. It's So there are some secrets here. That's why you want to be chopping these trees down. Of course, if you know where they are, you can just... like, never mind chopping everything down, but... there's either two or three areas you can find by chopping down these trees. That's a hard line here, all the way up here. I think it's mostly down south that you find the stuff. That's... I got a line back there. See, it's like clogging up... I mean, not clogging. Clearing out the fog of war in Baldur's Gate. I wonder... So I was going to say that. If we can find two axes, we'll both... kind of annoying how it says that every time, isn't it? Oh, so that's a hard line there. But this is not. Oh, we found some goodies. Alright, so we got arrows. Here we got arrow plus one. Plus one. I was just going to add it to my quiver. Yeah, I don't know. I guess... I don't know if you use the plus one arrows first. So... how many do we find? We almost got all the ones back that Planetdune couldn't import in. So here we got a longbow. Which I guess is better than a bow. I think it's slower, but does more damage. Chainmail. Just regular chainmail. That's it. Alright, so that's one of the secrets. Unfortunately, I didn't find the second axe yet. These things you can't chop down for whatever reason. Hack. Doesn't work. Clearing all this out. Now these you can't mess with. You figure they'd have inscriptions on them, but Gold Moon just says, with a disappointing frown, there seems little profit in disturbing the spirits of the fallen. Indeed. So what other things did I want to talk about? Inventory management, losing my mind over the MT-32. Yeah, I even have Munt. I'm playing it with Munt, which is an emulator. And I actually downloaded a SVN version of DOSBox, because some of those have Munt emulators in them, and it didn't work there either. I think I maybe just didn't, you know, configure it correctly. I'm not completely sure. Yeah, do not use DOSBox 0.74. Every time with sound effects, when you attack or something attacks you, there's this clicking, popping sound. It sucks. Yeah. So as you can see, the map doesn't show the details. What do you think, guys? Do you like it like this? Or should I just have it to where... you know, I want to move it, but you can move this map wherever you want. So I could have it off-screen, you know, and just move it in and just have this be the window. But, yeah, I'm open to suggestions on that. This came out in 1993. Yeah, considered not... a good version, a good game compared to the first two. It was not developed by Westwood. Westwood went on to do other things. They went on to be acquired by Virgin Interactive, I believe, and then they went off to do Lands of Lore series, which is good for, depending on who you talk to, good for one game, and then kind of went nuts. I mean, the second game looks interesting, but I heard the quality is not there. So, yeah, that's a dead end. So sometimes you'll see me click on these, because I got arrows for these, just not turning. I don't know if I can... set something up. So I'm just clearing the Frog of War. It's kind of a big area. Big outside area. I think there's a group of them back here. Yep. They can't go past even the little tree trunks. So you can do a smart like this. You can play the dance, but you can't. There's no animation of them moving. I mean, I guess you can see them moving to the side, but I don't. It's hard to tell whether they're new ones or the one you saw you killed, and then there's another one outside of you. It's kind of hard to tell. I mean, even the Eye of the Beholder, which came out in '87, is hard. It's easier to tell where things are moving and how. My God, they've got us surrounded. Amethyst actually lost a point somehow. Something probably attacked the side. So they're not hitting us because of our superior armor class. There's some kind of Glen or something in here. Oh, hi. Got our backs against the wall, or tree trunks, doesn't matter. Paramount attains level 10, gaining 3 points. Yay! Ready for Caramon. So, if anything else changes... nothing else would change. This is experience points and his, hit points. Gaining 3 hit points. Oh, we'll just show the hit points here, yeah. Not a lot of hit points for a fighter. Should gain more than that. I mean, typically, anyway. Okay, so these we can hack through. Just, I know we haven't explored everything up here, have we? Oh, here we got some stuff.